SPD family, I say that because that is what you are. You are my family. And family is honest with each other, and family has tough times, but in the end, we always remain family. We are all going through one of the toughest times ever in the history of the Seattle Police Department. I know how incredibly difficult these past 2 weeks have been for you and for your families. To say thank you will never probably be enough, but thank you. This department cares about you. I care about you. And although it may not seem true at this moment, your community cares about you. I want to update you all on the situation at the East Precinct. The decision to board up the precinct, our home, the first precinct I worked in, was something I have been holding off. You should know, leaving the precinct was not my decision. You fought for days to protect it. I asked you to stand on that line, day in and day out, to be pelted with projectiles, to be screamed at, threatened, and in some cases hurt. Then to have a change of course nearly 2 weeks in, it seems like an insult to you and our community. Ultimately, the city had other plans for the building and relented to severe public pressure. I'm angry about how this all came about. I understand that my comments in this message may be leaked to the public, but I'm not concerned about that. I stand by what I'm saying. We had solid information to believe that anti-government groups would destroy the precinct once we left, whether through vandalism or arson. As you might have heard, the Seattle Fire Department was nearby to protect the precinct and the entire residential block from a real risk of a large-scale fire. This week, there have been demonstrations and what I understand were threats against a news reporter on Capitol Hill. There was vandalism to our city streets and our building, but today the precinct remained standing. No officers were hurt, no force was used. We have heard that there are armed people patrolling the streets near 12th and Pine. Of course, this is very concerning, especially because we don't know who these people are. We've also received report that these armed people may be demanding payment from business owners in exchange for some of that protection. We've also heard that they may be demanding to see identification from people who live in the area. This is not legal. And we've asked anyone who may be experiencing this to come forward and file a police report so that we can investigate these crimes. In closing, I mostly just wanted to share how I feel. I am very thankful and very grateful for each and every one of you every single day. You are doing such incredible work, but I know you feel underappreciated. However, I do believe that most people in Seattle support the police department and its officers, even though they may not be the ones posting on social media. They and I will continue to have your backs to support you and appreciate all that you are doing in the name of public safety. Thank you and stay safe.